We study mechanotransduction, which is basically the study of forces, intracellular forces inside cells. And the way we measure this is using fluorescent microscopy.
What we're interested in is developing tools to sort of enhance the study of biology or cell biology. So we have biosensors. They're basically molecular strain gauges. We can insert those into specific proteins we're interested in the cell, and then we're able to measure the forces on those proteins and determine if those forces change in response to various chemical and mechanical stimuli.
We have cellular incubators where we keep live cells in. We also have fluorescent microscopes right behind me where we can view our cells and see whether the probes that we insert in them are actually working. And then if they are working, we'll take them over to the nanomaterialization characterization lab and we'll look at them there with more precise instruments. We also have some extra space over there where we do molecular cloning. That's where we edit DNA and then we insert the DNA into cells. Forces on cells kind of control their behavior. So for instance, if you put stem cells on a stiff substrate, they might be more likely to become a bone cell, versus if you put them on a soft substrate, they might be more likely to become a fat cell. So there is this very tight connection between the forces that cells experience and then how they behave, how they react.
Our group is specifically focused on two regions of the cell. The first is cell-cell junctions. That's where cells touch each other. And we're particularly interested in that because that is the region in which cells would mechanically communicate with each other. The second area we're very interested in the cell is the nucleus. Recent work in the last 5 or 10 years has shown that the nucleus is connected to the cellular cytoskeleton.
We've basically learned a lot about biophysics and imaging and optics, and also a little bit more about cellular biology.
A number of our students are actually able to write code and algorithms, and in our case we're processing a lot of large image data sets. But this kind of skill set could be used really for any kind of large data set.
There's lots of stuff going on, from cell biology to biomechanics to rehab engineering. So there's lots of different spaces that you can research in. Take your time when you're taking your classes, figure out what you're interested in, and then really focus on that.